This is part two of the Johnny Elisea interview. And remember, you are still in the Mavericks dojo.
You know what I'm talking about. Just let me know.
Okay, and on your experience with Daniel Pacino, what was that like?
Oh, man, it was awesome. It was great working with him because, growing up playing the first two games, and just to meet the guy who originally did all the moves for, like, Johnny Cage, Scorpion, Sub-Zero, Reptile, New Saigon Snow. But what was so great about Daniel Pacino is that I'll tell you the most miracle thing he did. It was on Sunday night, and then we were ready to shoot this the film on Monday. On Sunday night, the actor who was supposed to play Shang Tsung, he dropped out of the film. So everybody was like, "Oh, great! Now we don't have a Shang Tsung now." So Daniel Pacino stepped up and said, "You know what, guys? Let me play the role. I'll do it." And he was just there, just like to coordinate the fights and stuff like that. So, I mean, kind of stepping up, and taking the role. I mean, that was such a great thing he did. So working with him, it was an honor. And if I ever visit Chicago, I would definitely love to visit his school.
Oh man, so would I. So would I, definitely. Well, that's a wonderful, awesome experience, man. You know.
Yeah, I mean.
I'm sure you used to play with him back in the day when you played the game. You used to choose Johnny Cage.
Yeah, well, I always either played like Scorpion, Reptile, or Sub-Zero because, I was a big ninja fan back in the 90s. You know?
Who wasn't? Yeah, and now you were talking about, your involvement in the upcoming Netflix Luke Cage series. What's your involvement there?
My involvement was that I stand in for the actor Theo Rossi. You probably remembered him. He played as Juan Carlos in Sons of Anarchy. He's going to be playing Alvarez, Chase. So he's going to be playing one of the villains on the show that's coming up. And all I was doing, I was just standing in for him, and we were doing the promo shots and like the little trailers and all that good stuff. But he was such a very nice, humble guy, man. So I was able to talk to him, and he was great to work with. And then I also got to talk to Rosario Dawson. She is such a sweetheart.
You got to meet Rosario Dawson.
Yes, I was on set. I'm going to tell you a funny story.
I was thinking about her yesterday because she's one of my favorite actresses. She's so beautiful. My goodness.
I loved her in 7 Pounds, Sin City, and Death Proof. She was great. She's such a wow. But I'm gonna tell you a funny story. What happened? So all the other actors, after Rosario Dawson was doing her little her promo shots and stuff like that, after she was done stepping out, all the other guys, that was working with the other stand-ins, she's just passing by. These guys weren't even saying anything to her. So I said, "Hey, Rosario, how you doing?" She's like, "Hello." And I looked at these guys. And I was like, "Come on, guys. I mean, say something to her. Don't be all mute." And then they got in their face, and their faces turned red. I said, "Come on, open up to these people. I mean, do you want her to think that you're just a shy person?"
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but she is gorgeous in person.
Oh, my goodness. You got to see her in real life.
Yeah, I got to see her in real life. But you got to talk to her just for a bit, but not too long, though. So, and Mike Coulter, who plays Luke Cage, he's a very nice guy, too.
Did you get to meet him, too?
Yeah, we did a little, we were doing the stand-in, so, he was coming up next to us, and then, I just said hi, and that was it, and then we kept it going. He was a phenomenal Luke Cage. I love his performance in Jessica Jones. So I'm pretty sure he's going to knock it out of the park in this own series.
I'm ready for it.